call Roman discards. And the idea is that, well, I'll let you speak on this one, I know you know this.
The idea is, with not even discard, is that it allows you, when you pass the right card, which you regularly do, to signal your that you like or don't like a suit, depending on whether it's an even one or an odd one. And I think the original idea was that it allows you flexibility, and that you can encourage your partner in a suit by just playing a low odd spot card, or you could discourage by playing an even spot card, and it, because you're ready to have some odd ones and some even ones, if you needed to encourage in a suit but you didn't have an odd one, you could probably play an even one of a different suit. So, or you didn't have to waste, again, you didn't have to waste a high one to encourage, because again, it might be costing a trick. So it's sort of in the notion of allowing you flexibility in your signaling, because each even or odd card can tell a certain story, and one of your spot cards is great to be able to tell approximately the story that you want to. And Eddie's given us a little write-up here about what the spot cards mean in odd-even discard. Any even card tends to be not only discouraging, but tends to be able to be a suit preference discard. Saying, I don't like this one, the 2 says, try the lower one. The 8 says, I don't like this one, try the higher one. And any odd spot card tends to be encouraging in the suit that you discard. So you have a lot of flexibility to be able to direct your partner. And we all have had hands where we've had nothing but odd ones or even ones, which can be problematic playing odd even discard. But any card you have in any particular departing method could be problematic. But, yeah, go ahead. Versus upside down. We slightly prefer upside down card as opposed to odd even.
The reason we, this system is okay. If you are a little bit tired or maybe a little bit lazy when you're playing, this system works because 95% of the time you're going to have an odd card or an even card that works. However, that other 5% of the time when you do not have the right spot, which does come up about 5% of the time, you're going to make a discard, and your partner, if they follow it, they could end up with really bad consequences. However, when you play upside down, you always have a high card or you have a low card based on what the cards are that are remaining in the suit. So, actually, we do have a pretty good preference for upside down attitude as opposed to this method. But this method does have some going for it most of the time, about 95% of the time. You got about 5% of the time that it's not going to work. So, yes. Yes, definitely. Okay. The question was, how do you show suit preference with the card that you lead back? Alright, well, let's say partner leads the 9, and it looks like they're leading a double set. And we're sitting there with the 8, king, 8, suit. And we want to give our partner a rough. The dummy has the queen, jack, third. Something like this. We want to give our partner a rough, and we want to tell them how to get back to us.
We're going to go 9, we're going to play 2 spades, and we're going to lead one back.
Right. We're going to cash our 2 high ones, and then we're going to give partner a rough. Play back the 2 if you like the low suit. Play back the 8 if you like the high suit. Now I'm going to go one even further. That's going to help you even more. If you like the high suit, play your 8 king by playing 8 and then king. That will help partner. Tell if you like the high suit. 8, king, and then the 8. If you like the low suit, play king, 8, and then the
relative to this situation. You can't give suit preference. Not with your two.
Notice here, if you only have three, you can't even give suit preference. The only way you can give suit preference
is the order you play these guys.
Is the order in that in which you play your ace king. So here, play ace and king and give your partner a rough if you like the high suit. Play low and then high if you like the low suit.
Very important. This is common and it's just about every hand you play.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes, not even only applies to the first discard. And it does not apply in a suit that has already been led. In other words, the partner has led a suit and you've been forced to put up the king to protect his lead. And now you play the two in that suit, it just means what it would mean normally. It is not a Roman discard. That is part of the Roman discard situation that most people do not understand. A pitch in a suit that's already been played is not an odd even discard.
Yeah.
Okay?
Point. Yeah, you're very welcome.
Any other questions? Yes, sir.
Anybody else got a question?
Any other questions?